हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू आर सेफ एट होम. स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल गोइंग टू लर्न जीके यूनिट नंबर 9 ग्रेड पेपर रिवीजन. सो नाउ लेट्स डूइंग लर्न इन डिटेल. सो देर आर मैनी पीपल इन द वर्ल्ड दैट हू हैव बिकम वेरी वेल नोन बिकॉज ऑफ द गुड थिंग्स दे हैव डन फॉर अदर्स. सो they have become so famous that they have a world's know about them. So now let's learn about a first is Mahatma Gandhi. MAHATMAGANDHI. So here we can see a photograph of Mahatma Gandhi. So Mahatma Gandhi's full name, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. So you all know about Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi because he is our father of nation and we call Bapu. So he was a leader of nationalism in British rural India. He is more commonly called a Mahatma Gandhi. So Mahatma Gandhi is an honorific meaning great soul. So or venerable. So in a Sanskrit. So Mahatma Gandhi is a great people and also he is a great soul. He was the first called in 1940 in South Africa. He is also called a Bapu in India. So Mahatma Gandhi was the matriarch of the nation since 1948. Rabindranath Tagore gave him the title of Mahatma. Mahatma Gandhi was one of the most important people involved in the movement for independence India. So Mahatma Gandhi is a great person and our father of nation. He is the most important people involved in the movement for the independence of India. He was a non-violence activist who led the independence movement through a non-protest. So Mahatma Gandhi believes in non-violence and also he was a rural leader of nationalism British rural India, and his name Mahatma means great soul or venerable in Sanskrit. So Mahatma Gandhi is a Bapu of our India. Mahatma Gandhi is a great person and we know that, and we all celebrate 2nd October as a Gandhi Jayanti. So Mahatma Gandhi is a great people and also a very important people involved in the movement of independent India. So children, you all are understand about Mahatma Gandhi. So now we are going to learn a next great people, and it's a Mother Teresa. MOTHER TERESA. So Mother Teresa, here we can see a photograph of Mother Teresa. Mother Teresa is a great people. Mother Teresa was born in 1910 and died in 1997. But the love and kindness she left behind continues to impact our world. So Mother Teresa is related with love and kindness. Ask your parents about Mother Teresa and most likely you will get a smile and some pleasant words. This woman found a great joy in helping people with real needs like hunger, sickness, lack of shelter and lack of clothing and even loneliness. So Mother Teresa is a great person and also she helping people in many various types like hunger, sickness, lack of shelter and lack of clothing and even loneliness. So Mother Teresa's love of service was motivated by her strong Catholic faith. Mother Teresa showed the face of God in every person. Mother Teresa is a pure soul and no matter the skin color, religion, language or faults, Mother Teresa see the every person in God. And no matter the skin color, religion, language or faults, looking for the faults in other was not the way to love them. She believes that helping those in need is the way we as human serve God. So Mother Teresa is a great person and she is a look for love and kindness. So Mother Teresa is a great person. She helping a people also in such a way like a sickness, a lack of shelter, loneliness and lack of a clothing. So Mother Teresa is a great person and she helped the poor and sick people. Mother Teresa helped poor and sick people. So children's Mother Teresa is a great person. Now we are going to learn a next person. And it's a Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath. Rabindranath Tagore. Tagore. So here we can see a photograph of Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore is a famous Bengali poet. And Rabindranath Tagore born in 7th May 1861 and died on 7th August 1941 was an Indian poet of India. His name is written as Rabindra Thakur in Indian languages. He was also a philosopher and artist. He wrote many stories, novels, poems and dramas. And he is well known for composing music. His writing greatly influenced in Bengali culture during the late 19th century. So, and the early 20th century, in 1930, he won the Nobel Prize in Literature. He was the first Asian even to win this prize. So, Rabindranath Tagore won the Nobel Prize in 1930 and he was a very famous famous poet and writer. And also, our national song Jana Gana Mana is written by Rabindranath Tagore. So, Rabindranath Tagore is famous for their work like poetry, poems, stories and novels. And he is a Bengali poet and also he won a Nobel Prize in 1930 and he is influenced in Bengali culture and his writing is greatly influenced in Bengali culture. So Rabindranath Tagore is a very famous poet and also a novelist. He write a many things and many such a novel. So Rabindranath Tagore is a great people. So now we are going to learn a next slide and next person, and it's a Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, PANDITJAWAHARLALNEHRU, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. So here we can see a photograph of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. He was the first Prime Minister of India. So Nehru born on November 14, 1889 in Allahabad, India. As a child, he learned the Hindi, Sanskrit and English languages. In 1905, he went to England where he studied science and law. In 1912, he returned to India and became a lawyer in Allahabad. So, in 1947, Jawaharlal Nehru became the first Prime Minister or leader of India. For more than 20 years, he had worked with Mahatma Gandhi to free India from British rule. So, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru is a work with Mahatma Gandhi to free India from British rule. 20 years he had worked. The Indian people call him the Pandit, which means a wise man. Pandit means a wise man. So the Indian people is call him a Pandit. So Jawaharlal Nehru is as a child he learned Hindi, Sanskrit and English languages. In 1905 he went to England where he studied science and law, and in 1912 he returned to Allahabad and became a lawyer in Allahabad. So in 1947 Jawaharlal Nehru became the first Prime Minister or leader of India. So Jawaharlal Nehru loved children, and also he is worked with Mahatma Gandhi to free India from British rule. So the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru is a great person and also a great man and first president of India. So children, you all are understand about Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. So now we are going to learn a Lata Mangeshkar. Here we can see a photograph of Lata Mangeshkar. LATAMANGESHKAR. So Lata Mangeshkar is a famous, very famous Indian singer. Lata Mangeshkar is melodic queen of India. Lata Mangeshkar has ruled over the haters of hearts over the millions of music lovers throughout the world for the last 40 years by the magic of her melodious voice. So Lata Mangeshkar has ruled over the hearts of millions of people, music lover throughout the world for the last 40 years by the magic of her melodious voice. She was born in Indore, Madhya Pradesh, in family of musician. So Lata Mangeshkar was born in a musician family, and she took a signing at the age of 13, She has a sang a song based on classical Indian music and rock. Lata Mangeshkar sang a song on based on classical Indian music and rock. Bhajans or devotional songs, romantic and melodic songs and so on. So Lata Mangeshkar's voice is melodious voice, and she is a very famous Indian singer. Lata's name has come in Guinness Book of Record as the singer of highest number of songs. So Lata Mangeshkar come in Guinness Book of World Record and as a singer of the highest number of songs. She has already sung over 30,000 songs in a variety of languages. So Lata Mangeshkar is a very famous and melody queen of India, and she was born in Indore in a family of musician, and she has sang songs based on classical Indian rags, music, bhajan or devotional songs, and romantic and melodic songs and so on. So she sang a song so many languages or variety of languages. So Lata Mangeshkar is a great people. So now we are going to learn a next person, and it's A.R. Rahman. So here we can see a photograph of A.R. Rahman. A.R. Rahman is full name Allah Rakha Rahman. Original name is A.S. Dilip Kumar. Born on January 6, 1966 in Madras, now it's Chennai in India. So he is an Indian composer whose extensive body of work for film and stage entered him the nickname the Mozart of Madras. So A.R. Rahman's nickname is Mozart of Madras, because he is born in Madras. Rahman's father R.K. Shekhar was prominent Tamil musician who composed scores for the Malayalam film industry, and Rahman began studying piano at the age of 4. The boy's interest lay in electronics and computers, and his father serendipitous purchase of synthesizer allowed him to pursue his passion and learn to love music at the same time. So A.R. Rahman's father is helping her to his passion, and also he is a famous Indian music director. So Rahman is a very famous Indian music director. So children, you all are understand about A.R. Rahman. So now we are going to learn a Pratibha Patil. So here we can see a photograph of Pratibha Patil, and she is the first prime minister. She is first woman prime minister, and Pratibha Patil born in December 19, 1934 in Jalgaon, Maharashtra, India. She is an Indian lawyer and politician Who was the first woman to serve as a president of India? So, Pratibha Patil is the first president of India in 2007 to 2012. So, Patil entered a master's degree in political science and economics at the Molji Jetha College and Jalandhar, and later received a law degree from the Government Law College in Mumbai. She joined the Indian National Congress Party and entered politics in 1962 as a member of the Maharashtra Legislative Assembly. So, Pratibha Patil is a first woman to president of India, and she is a very famous economics and also a learner in Molji Jetha College, and also she is a lawyer and politician. And she is a member of a Congress Party and Maharashtra Legislative Assembly. So, children, you all are understand about Pratibha Patil. So, now we are going to learn a next slide and next person. It is a Walt Elias Disney. W-A-L-T-E-R, Walter Elias, Elias, Disney. So, you all are familiar with Walter Elias Disney. Here we can see a photograph of Walt Disney. And Walter Elias Disney, born on December 5, 1901, and died on December 15, 1966, was an American business magnate, animator and cartoonist, producer, screenwriter, interpreter and voice actor. So Walt Disney is well known for around the world in cartoon film, and also created a character of Donald Duck. So, Disney was an important person in the American animation industry, and throughout the world, he is regarded as an international icon and philanthropist. He is well known for the influence and contribution to the field of entertainment during the 20th century. And along with her brother Roy Disney, he was the founder of Walt Disney Production, and the corporation is now known as the Walt Disney Company. So, Walter Disney is also made a number of cartoon films, and also created the character of Donald Duck, Mickey Mouse and so on. And he was an important person in American animation industry. So, children, you all are understand about Walt Disney. Now we are going to learn a next person, and it's Annette Blyton. So, Annette Blyton, here we can see a photograph of Annette Blyton. E-N-I-D-B-L-Y-T-O-N, Annette Blyton. So, Annette Blyton, born on 11th August 1897, and died on 28 November 1968. She was an English author. She was born in Dulwich, South London, in England. She was one of the world's most famous children writers, and She is well known for the children's novel. The most famous children writer. She is also one of the most prolific authors of all the time. As a child and teenager, her main interest has been writing poems, stories, and other items. She has sent many themes or magazines, but had never had any public. As she worked as a teacher, she began to have articles about children and education printed in a magazine called A Teacher World, Teacher's World. Her first book called Child Whisper came out in 1922. It was a book of her poem with a illustration. So, Annette Blyton is a very famous children writer and author. She writes so many books and magazines on children. So Annette Blyton is born also a child and teenage interest in child and teenagers and writing poems. She was as a child and a teenager age, she write poems and stories and other items. And also, she was a famous children writer. And her first book called A Child Whisper is come out in 1922. So it was a book of her poem with her illustrations. So in today's lecture, we are learn about great people like Mahatma Gandhi, Mother Teresa, and then Rabindranath Tagore, and then Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Then we learn about Lata Mangeshkar, A.R. Rahman, Pratibha Patil, and Walt Disney, and then Annette Blyton. So children, you all are enjoy. Hope you all are learn and enjoy this video. So students, I will see you next time. And also students, don't forget to wash your hand regularly, eat healthy food, stay home and stay safe. Thank you students.